Okay, what? Oh yeah, that's just that. Hello everybody and welcome back to Let's Play Final Fantasy XIV. So it is another day, it's a new day in the world of bullshit. It's currently... Actually, I'm going to change... Until I'm mining, I'm going to change this back to... Yeah, I'll switch it to local time. Well, the local time is almost exactly the same. So it's 8:14 in the morning for me. That way I can keep an eye on the time just in-game, which is incredibly useful. Something's up my ass. So, last time we were... Oh, okay. That's for the quest. Alright, apparently I have to actually mine for the quest. So last time we were working quite a bit on the story. Well, Dingle's not here right now. I didn't know if we were going to actually play any tonight or last night because I got up, 6 hours ago or so. I didn't know if we were going to be playing any, but it looks as though that would not be the case for right now. So I'm not going to touch the story just yet without pissing them off until I have the confidence to continue anyhow. But I do have stuff to do, so obviously one of the first things I kind of want to work on is the job quest that we were going to do before we continued the story, because that would be helpful. I also want to reorganize some of my stuff here, some of my skills, and kind of work on that a little bit. And then I also would like to finally work on some of the crafting stuff, because that's a thing that I would like to do. Crafting and also the botanist. Or whatever it's called. I don't remember. Yeah, botanist. I did look into... So one of the things I also need to do is hire a second retainer. Or at least see what is required to hire a second retainer. That way I can store more stuff. But also, I was told that you can get up to like 7 additional retainers. So you can have 9 in total, I think. And you pay for them, obviously, with real money, right? And I was like, okay, well, if you just go to the Mog Station and you buy another retainer for $5 or something, I didn't think that would be too bad. I wasn't going to do it right now, but I didn't think it would be too bad. Well, we went to the Mog Station and found that you actually have to add additional cost to your subscription. Like, fuck that shit. I'm not going to pay more money for a subscription just to have extra retainers. So at least right now I'm not doing that. Alright, so no, we're not doing that. Let's open up our urinal here. Oh, right, I never actually got the quest. Okay, well let's go get it. So it's in the South Shroud, which is thankfully right next to us. So let's head on off. I'll do this first because I know that there is some skills and stuff I could get access to after completing this. And also with the story stuff we've been doing recently, we've been progressing quite far in our venture. So at some point we're going to hit level 50 with Bard, Archer, whatever you want to refer to it as. And when that happens, I'm going to want to do the next piece. Okay, well, there's really nothing I can do in there right now. Ring, ring, ring. I have to try to remember how these hot bars work. I just want to move around some of my skills for this particular class. Because when I was doing the dungeon, I was fumbling over everything, pressing the wrong keys. I also have to be wary because my recording software is both my backup software and my primary software are tied to the number keys. So, like, for example, on the numpad, that's my primary recording software hotkeys. And then the, whatever you call the row of numbers at the top of your keyboard that are not the numpad, that's my other recording software. Once you get to the 8 key, you know, like these skills here, that's where my secondary recording software is bound to, the 8 and 9 keys. So I have to find some alternatives. And I was thinking about like moving these off, or at least bringing them over here or something temporarily. And I was going to put some of the support buffs and stuff over here so that I can just click them. Like, I don't think, do I have any right now? Like this one, for example, I could do, Ordeal. Oh, shoot. I'm trying to see which one it is. Or the one that I think I will get from this job quest that'll buff the party. So I want to move that one over here. That way it's not there. And I also would like to combine 3 and 5 because both of these are like tick damage. So you got poison and then this wind damage. And they both this one lasts 30 seconds, this one lasts 50 seconds, but I have to keep bouncing over the 4 key to hit 3 and 5. So I just want to stick those together, and I might want to bring 4 to 3, I'm not sure. Obviously, my brain is like muscle memorying to these particular keys, so it'll take some adjustments. I'll definitely be fucking up quite a bit, probably, once I move them around, but that's to be expected. Anywho, we're almost to where I need to be going. For our quest. Alright, let us see what is of required for me. Oh, shit. Well, he's not here yet. But he'll be right there. There he is. Hello there! Bard's Eye View. Alright. Accept. Call me a spoony bard. Oh my god, look at the bow that person's got. Where do I get something like that? This may seem far-fetched upon first hearing. This isn't so far-fetched. Oh my god, the dog and puppy, look! The dog and puppy. I mean, the cat and puppy. Look, they're freaking getting angry at each other. That's epic. Just two random pets doing that. That was kind of cute. Oh, they're gonna do it again! Apparently they can fly. Warwick Wood, pair of Ald goats, and have but recently lost a kid. They have been driven mad with grief, and only death will put an end. Oh, what? I have to go and slaughter things that lost their children? What am I listening to? Linger in their territory and then let fly your arrows of mercy. Okay, I'll make sure to do that. Alright, well, for the sake of right now, I'm going to, since I now know that you can hide these, I'm going to hide that one. And this will be my primary one. Method for acquiring a new melody, of which I don't even remember how the melody thing works.
Wait, specify destination. Yeah.
Okay, and that is located Wellwick Wood, which is back in Eastern Thanaland, right to the north of Eastern Thanaland. So right at the entrance of the Shroud. I was going to say, I thought that's where those goat things were. Yeah, I don't remember anything about like this. I just know that it's a thing. that it fills up or whatever as you do stuff. And I don't know if it's just as you use your buffs on your party. I don't really remember, but... Boy. They got one hell of a freaking chocobo going there. I don't have no chocobo. Fuckabo. My mind was wandering again. My bad. I did not mean to allow that to happen. Where is it at? Up on that ridge up there? Well, dude, I don't want these little shits to attack me. Awaiting, I am. Oh, fucker. Alright, this is what you want to do then? Then you may have it. Oh yeah, you can't moo, you're a goat. What? Oh, my bad. Dead. Right, it looks like he wishes for me to return to him. That wasn't such a bad task. I brought mercy to a mother and father that just lost their child, and the mercy was slaughtering them. Awesome. I mean, I get the idea. They were just in this fit of rage because they couldn't accept what had happened. But, I mean, come on. I got a cut of Aldgoat Chuck, I got a horn skins, and I got a high quality horn, too. Okay. Well, if that's all that I needed to do, that was an easy-ass job quest. But I am not of the certain yet. Now, as for these crafting skills and the botany, I don't exactly know what cities to find the starts of those in. Just one egg, I ask. I think Goldsmith or Blacksmith or one of the smithies are in Ulda. I'm pretty sure I remember seeing one of those. And a botanist, I almost feel like that would be here in the green region. I mean, you know, it's trees and plants. But then again, I don't know. I don't know if it tells you. I think you just have to go to the cities. Well, the thing I'm going to do after this is I'm going to look and see if I can find where to hire another, whatchamacallit from, another retainer. I think it's by a market board in any of the major cities. So... that shouldn't be too hard. Get out of here. I have returned, sir. Oh, that was literally it. And now we've got a cutscene. You hear a faint voice. My song gauge has been expanded, apparently. Wait, I can do another one? Is it every 5 levels? Doing it the bard way. Oh, it is, 45. Because I just leveled up from that quest, I get to do my next one just right away. Okay, let me see this. Singing army's peon, whatever, will display the action's corresponding song gauge, indicating the effect's time remaining. The repertoire effect is triggered while army's ding-dong is being sung. The bard is granted reduced cast time and recast time, spell cast time and recast time, and auto-attack delay according to the number of stacks accumulated. Singing Mage's Ballad will display the action's corresponding song gauge, indicating the effect's time remaining. If the repertoire effect is triggered while Mage's Ballad is being sung, the recast times for Bloodletter and Reign of Death... Okay, that's Bloodletter. Don't know what Reign of Death is. Oh, Reign of Death learned at level 45. Okay, our reset. I'm so confused. You can view the job gauge description at any time from the actions and traits menu. Okay. So, yeah, see, I've got this thing now. So it deals unaspected damage with a potency of 100. It grants that thing to all party members within 30 yalms, increasing their direct hit rate by 3%. Now, there's a 20% chance to grant repertoire when damage over time is dealt by Venomous Bite or Wind Bite. But does that mean I have to cast Venomous Bite or Wind Bite first? Or do that after? The repertoire effect will reduce weapon skill cast time and recast time, spell cast time and recast time, and auto attack delay by 4%. Can be stacked up to 4 times. This action does not share a... Okay. So, like, this is the kind of thing I would stick over here, like that. In fact, I'm going to move my instrumentes over here, and I'm just going to stick... Probably going to stick that over there. Triples the number of strikes for a single target weapon skill. I don't know what that means. Does that just mean if I use like heavy shot, it'll do it 3 times? Oh, right here, I've got Mage's Ballad already. I just haven't been using it. Okay. Deals unaspected damage. Yeah. Grants Mage's Ballad to all party members with 30... No. What am I doing? Which will increase their damage dealt by 1%. Oh, my God. For 30 seconds. 20% chance to grant repertoire. Okay, again, that's Venomous Bite or Wind Bite, which will reset cast... timer. I don't get, is that, do I have to cast Venomous Bite before or after, or does it matter?
That is the only thing I am confusion.
Now my ass itches. Okay, so, actions and traits. There, I've got that, and I'll get Reign of Death next, apparently. Delivers an attack with a potency of 130 to target and all enemies nearby, so it's an AoE. Shares a recast timer with Bloodletter. So, I can either use Bloodletter or that. Well, I can always alternate if I want. There's a lot of fucking shit in there to learn. That's my traits. All right, so let me see. So I'm going to take Mage's Ballad. I'm going to put it there. I'm going to take the Army's Peon, whatever it is. Put that over there. Okay. Let's take this at 5. Move that up for a second. So I'm going to move Bloodletter over, and I'm going to put... Actually, you know what? Here's what I'm going to do. We're going to put Bloodletter at 3, and then we're going to put Venomous Bite at 4 and Wind Bite kept at 5, and I'll keep that at 6, the Quick Knock. And then Head Graze, which interrupts the use of a target's action, which I never have seemed to be able to get that to work. Actually, we're going to move this over, but then that'll get on to 7. I'm going to move this over here as well. Okay, that's going to have to be the best I can do right now. Hopefully it works. Well, let's do the next one. Since we're here, might as well. We'll learn Reign of Death, which might actually be kind of nice. Greetings, I have seen you in not long time. What? Okay, I can do that. The bouquet of lilies at the resting place, which is just where what North Shroud. Okay, we are in. Okay, we're in the South Shroud. Oh, Lord. All right, we can do that. I don't know, maybe I should try to just cast this just willy-nilly right now just to see if it makes this bar fill up. That way I kind of get a better understanding. I might even have to just watch a freaking YouTube video tutorial to figure it out. This will be good. I feel good about being level 45 right now. No doubt we're gonna blast ahead when we start doing this story again. Go on, straight to the north. Northwest. Just trying to think of some things. I'm just... Oh, here, let me... Actually, there's a repair thing here. How's my gear? My gear's fine. Ow, ow, ow. And I've got things to do later today, so... I'm probably not going to be playing for too awful long. I mean, when I say later today, I mean, you know, hours and hours ahead, not just an hour and a half or something. But we'll see. I'm not quite sure exactly. That person is disconnecting, maybe? They have RP on their name. So, no, well, I won't... I was gonna start talking about the crafting and gathering skills and stuff, but I'll do that after. I'll do that when we actually go to do it. I'll explain kind of what plan I have, because there was a little bit more foreplanning required. Now, I don't know, like, all the specifics of what each crafting skill does yet or not. I just have a rough idea. So, we're just gonna have to touch... We're just gonna have to touch each of them a little bit and see which ones I need to focus on. Because I'd like to be able to start crafting my own gear that's at least better. I'm not sure how it works, though. Oh boy, a little tired. Nameless Conjurer. Do you guys still get angry at me? No. Okay. Aha, I have surpassed you in power. And I'm assuming once I place these lilies down, I'll have to walk all the way back to him. I thought he wanted me to guide him there. Evidently, that does not matter. That is a detail that is not required. Oh, the footsteps have disappeared. Oh, okay, they're back. I think, hey, we did the... I remember standing on this pier talking about my new mount. I think I took screenshots down here of it. I still have memories of this game. I remember doing a story thing in there. Why is there a big motherfucker here? Hey, I have to do something here. Smells like tree spirit. Well, it's literally right next to that guy. I hope this doesn't... What does that description say? Offerings to the dead. Duty calls. Doing it the bard way. All right. The tonal shift in the music has changed quite a bit. Oh, he is here. Excuse me. Whoa. What, stuff's getting dark all of a sudden? He's getting PTSD. No, now's not the time. Alright, looks like I'm gonna have to take the step up for this one. I'm not gonna blame him. I don't know what's going on with his little with his brain right now, but he's run off to leave me. Alright, here, let us. I'm going to venom you. I'm going to do this. We are still going to do this. Watch out there. I'm trying my best to try to get used to the new skill lineup that I've given myself. Ow! What the fuck was that? Oh, there's a caster back there. Oh no, is he gonna start fucking healing? Just when I almost killed that guy. Alright. Like it, don't you? Switch target. Alright. Alright, that wasn't too bad. I think the skill set that I moved around, resorted, works out. What the hell are they doing here? Oh my god, why is this so dark? It almost made me cry. How you know you have a melody brooming with inside you. Or brewing, not brooming. Brewing is that your hand starts glowing. Your empathy unlocks echoes of an ancient melody within you. Okay. Oh, I don't want to be in a fate here. Alright, so, yeah, he just wants me to go Barack Obama. I can do that. That was interesting. I like that.